A very pleasant morning to you all, children. Last class we were discussing about vegetative propagation. It is also type of reproduction in which the vegetative parts, like I had discussed, root, stem and leaves can give rise to new plant. Got it? Now, vegetative propagation we had discussed in detail about how does it take place. We had taken the example of rhizome, we have taken the example of bulb, tuber, whatever. Now, vegetative propagation can also take place with the help of leaves. Whatever. Now, there is a particular leaf which is referred as bryophyllum. Whatever. What is its name? Bryophyllum. Most of the new plant grows with the help of seeds. But here, what happens in this particular plant? What do we find? Along the margin, tiny bud develops which give rise to leaves and adventitious roots. Got it? So, what happens if you detach? Detach means cut a part of the leaf having the tiny buds or the young leaves with the adventitious root and grow it in a pot. Place it. What do we find? A new plant develops. So, this is what? Vegetative propagation through leaves. This all what we had discussed, that was natural vegetative propagation. Clear? I have also mentioned that vegetative propagation can take place artificially. So what are those different methods? Now, what we are going to discuss? We are going to discuss that how artificial vegetative propagation takes place. Artificial. Got it? Now the first type is called as cutting. This is very common. Now, when you grow a new plant with the help of seeds, it takes a long time. So, what do the gardeners and farmers do, generally the horticulturists? They, suppose this is the soil, they take any branch, part of the plant, like the rose cutting, and place it in the soil. Cut it. This is the cut part, having nodes, internodes, and a tiny bud. Cut it. They place it in the moist soil, add rooting hormone and organic fertilizers. Very soon, this will develop into a new plant. This is called as cutting. So in the method of cutting, what do? We take a part of the stem or a branch, that particular plant having two or three buds, nodes and internodes, and places obliquely. Obliquely means planting in the soil and cover it with the moist soil and add water to it. Wait for a few days. You find that this buds will again develop adventitious roots and give out a new branch. And this will develop into leaves, buds will develop into flower. So this method is cutting. Now, the next artificial method is layering. Clear? Layering. In layering, cutting what I said, it is very common in rose plant. Layering is common in plants as jasmine and strawberry. These are very common in usually done. Now what happens? Like suppose when we talk about, I'm not going to pull diagram, shrubs. Shrubs generally have branches that rise from the basal part. Clear? These are the branches given out by the main plant. this is the stem and the branches. In nearly what happens, the lowermost branch, got it? The lowermost branch, it is bent towards the soil. What happens? This is soft, so the tip part is bent towards the soil, and what happens? The growing tip is kept above the soil. Clear? Now, what happens? These are the already, the leaves are already present there, maybe flower also. What I said, in nearly the plant having numerous branches, generally the shrubs, the lowermost branch is bent towards the soil and its tip kept above the soil. The bent part is covered with soil. After few days, adventitious roots develop. Got it? And when you cut the part of the branch at that point, this will develop into a new plant. So this method is called as layering. Clear? Now, the next part of artificial propagation, vegetative propagation, is grafting. Now, in the method of grafting, you require what? Two parts, scion and stalk. Whereas, if you ask the difference between cutting and grafting, cutting requires only one plant. Layering and grafting, two implants. Layering one plant, grafting two plant. Got it? Of the same species. So, stalk is the root part and scion is the upper part of the stem. So, scion is the upper part of the stem and stalk will be the lower part of the plant. That is usually the root region. Here. So, what is grafting? It is a method of artificial vegetative propagation in which two different individuals, different plants but belonging to the same species, are taken and are grafted one above the other. Got it? So, that's all for this session. Next class, I will tell you in detail how grafting is done. So, by this method of grafting, you can get new varieties, both in flowering plants as well as fruit bearing plants. So, just remember, scion, upper part of the stem, that is the plant, and stalk, the lower part of the plant, that is the fruit region. So, that's all. Stay home, be safe.